Hey guys, what I thought we'd do, just bumped the microphone there, is read the courier. I don't know why, but I just thought I would, we can start on the first page. I do like to read it. I like to know what's going on locally. I like to know what's going on nationally, internationally and locally. But it's just fine. It's, when you get sat down in the evening, you're so tired, you just think, oh, you just want to chill. But anyway, I like to read the Courier when I can. I don't ever read it every week. But the front page is about going from left to right. And there's a woman with a couple of carrots in her hand, and it's magic carrots, she says. Myra Smith, community champion for Morrison's Dumfries, has been giving wonky carrots to children for free to feed Rudolph and the rest of the hungry reindeer. He's a fair age. With this move, Morrison's aims to introduce kids to wonky veg, encourage families to buy large or misshapen carrots, and help our busy parents who might have otherwise forgotten a gift. Okay. And then we've got Flood Plan Challenge, which is on the right there. It's a special meeting called by council administration. 13 members push for scrutiny, councillors to revisit plan, barrier boss questions costs, silly stunt, says Labour. I don't know if it flooded. It was certainly very high, the river. No, I think if flooding was imminent, but I've not heard if it has. And it says Tales of Christmas Past, page 10. And the news is top Tories poll shock. Party ticket lost by 3. Page 13. Sport Ice Stars in Dumfries International at the Bull, page 39. Spotlight, Jolly Jumpers were a hit, page 18. And you've got a few adverts here. It's Thompson, Roddick, the auctioneers, and it's LIP Construction Limited. And then there's another thing about this seasonal stuff. I'm going to stop this just a second before I go on to the next page. I'm just going to take out the highlights of this paper. There's some of it. I'm going to take out the highlights. I'm going to stop this and just test the volume on this recording. Now the audio seems to be okay. A little bit tinny. To be honest, I did some work for a friend and I didn't expect paid. I was just doing them a favour, you know. Maybe it's so tinny because I'm so far away. I'll try to bring the mic a bit closer, just about there. Maybe it's just struggling to pick me up. Got a terrible cold, sniffy nose. What was I going to say? I did him a favour and he just gave me a gift card for £25 and I thought, well, I'd like a DAB radio. I'd also like, I looked at a microphone, like an IC, is it Ice Blue or something? Something like that. I thought, oh, that would be a handy thing, and it was £50. I thought I'd only have to put £25 to it, but the radio was £25. And I think I must be a bit mean, because I bought the radio. And I kind of wish I'd bought the microphone, but anyway, the radio will be handy. I'll get the microphone at some point. I'm maybe going to have a look on eBay. Have a look, see how much they are on eBay, the microphones, because it'd be worth it. I quite enjoy talking. But I'm going to open to the second page of the Courier. Let's have a look. What have we got going on here? And give me a wee second just to test my adjustments to the microphone. The microphone is okay, it's picking up the volume fine. I can do things, I can adjust it. Anyway, page 2 of the Courier, dated Friday, December 23rd, 2016. Okay, and it says a transport firm in bid for 80 homes on site. Okay, a bid to create. Oh, that's up at the Currys, isn't it? Lockerbie. Oh, aye. A bid to create 80 homes at Lockerbie has been officially lodged by a Dumfries haulage company. Curry European have set out the proposal for a mixture of homes, shops, a pub or restaurant, and a warehouse once it vacates the site. It's currently eyeing two alternative locations within the region. Tom Barry, the company's owner, said, "We are delighted to announce that we have submitted an application to Dumfries and Galloway Council. The redevelopment of our site on Edinburgh Road will really benefit the community by providing space for new local facilities." Well, that's quite interesting. And with a public exhibition having taken place on November 17th to set out the company's developing plans, Mr. Barry added, "We were also very happy with the pre-application consultation process, taking on the feedback from residents and incorporating some of the suggestions in our final submission. Communication with the community is key, and we will ensure that residents continue to be updated throughout the application process and thereafter." I think that's end of quote. This proposed redevelopment is part of Curry European's plans to relocate to a more suitable site. Curry have been based in Dumfries since 1977 and say the move is needed to secure its long-term future and existing workforce in Dumfries and Galloway. Their proposals include residential development of the site on the site of the trailer park, consisting of approximately 80 houses. I'll read that again. Their proposals include residential development on the site of the trailer park, consisting of approximately 80 houses with associated landscaping and provision of open space. The plans also show a 1,000 metre square Class 4 and Class 6 warehouse unit on the site of the Curry European warehouse. Curry European say they hope the application can ensure the provision of some local amenities for neighbouring communities. And it says there was positive feedback at last month's exhibition, with local residents indicating that they would like to see some family-friendly facilities opening in the area. That sounds good. It's a quote from Tom Barry then in big highlighted letters. "We will ensure that residents continue to be updated throughout the application process and thereafter." Tom Barry. Fine. Now, unless the weather's next, and it says Saturday, sunny spells and squally showers for a time, and that was true. And Sunday will be dull with rain. And Monday, a mixture of sunny spells and scattered showers. Fine. And it's got the tide times for relevance. What does it say there? So Sunday it will be 9:20 a.m., 9:51 p.m. and so on. Oh dear, sorry about the nose. Oh, I've got the sand bit here. And on page, where are we now? I think we're on page 3. It says, there's a picture of some people there, quite a few people. Who are they? Ah, yes, I recognise some of them. They're shopkeepers, yes. You've got Holt Cole, councillors Ian Carruthers, Jack Groom, Graham Bell, and Yen Hong Mi Jin join White Sands business owners. Just try to find, that's obviously a Chinese bloke, isn't it? Yes, it is, she's a lady. Sorry, not a bloke. She's a lady, I see her now, yes, sorry. Oh dear. But they join these business owners on the White Sands and residents as they call for a halt to progress on a 25 million flood protection and regeneration scheme. Sands recall bid is the headline. A last-ditch attempt by councillors to challenge the £25 million White Sands scheme has proved successful. Wait a minute, let's read that again. Okay, they've challenged it. Something's come of it. 12 signatures were needed to bring the flood prevention and regeneration project back for further scrutiny at full council, with 13 out of the region's 47 councillors stepping forward to sign their names. Leader of the Dumfries and Galloway Independent Group Council, Ian Carruthers, said, "It's a clear message for the council that there's a desire to look again at this whole White Sands." At a meeting of the Environment Committee on Monday, Councillor Carruthers had appealed for a delay on green lighting the project until after the council elections in May. Instead, councillors voted to sign off on the project by 12 votes to 5. But noting public doubts over the project, which has included a petition with more than 10,000 signatures, Councillor Carruthers said that the whole purpose of a councillor is to represent the constituents that they've been elected in to represent. In real terms, if you look at the Dumfries councillors, I'd be walking around with my head hung low, voting for a project that was that the local community doesn't want. Councillor Carruthers notes the raised earthen walkway scheme being taken forward was presented to councillors in 2015 with a price tag of about £15 million. But he said the costings are now nearer £25 million, and that's a material difference, it certainly is. We need to come back and revisit the three options that are there at that time. Two alternate approaches involving a self-rising flood barrier rejected, with the arguments that they would be too costly. Construction consultants McGowan Miller has costed a self-rising barrier into the river wall at £22 million to £26.1 million, and 1.5 metres back at £15.8 million to £20.3 million. Flood Specialist UK Flood Barriers had proposed and costed a self-rising barrier for the sands at £9 million. And this week the firm had backed CEO Frank Kelly's original figure when he said there's no way it'd be £18 million to £26 million. So I said £9 million and it's £9 million. The Labour Administration have branded the latest development a silly stunt that would cost Dumfries £20 million of government funding, claiming an extra cost of £25,000 for each week the scheme is delayed due to 3% construction inflation, and claiming the move delays publication of the final plans. Councillor Ted Thompson said, "It is disappointing that some councillors clearly don't want the public to see the actual detailed scheme." And he argues that the increasing costs do not impact on the £5 million required from the council to fund the scheme. He said they also know perfectly well that the alternate schemes that they previously rejected will cost millions more than the preferred option. It's clear that this has nothing to do with the funding, and it's little more than a silly stunt to get publicity. Okay. Oh, I'm going to stop a minute and blow the nose. So on page 3, there's actually quite a bit more about this flood. It says, a businessman plans objection. A car spares firm on the White Sands says, flood barrier and regeneration project is now a greater threat to the business than the flooding itself. John Greenwood of 252 Spares this week said, "In its current form, I would say that this was the case." Mr. Greenwood says he plans to lodge a strenuous objection in the 28-day window once final plans are published for the raised walkway and wall with glass panelling and demountable panels, set to be constructed over a period of up to 2 years. Opponents fear the impact on trade, parking and river views. Mr. Greenwood says he will assess progress by confirming he might look to relocate the business, he said. It is certainly not desirable, but it's an option. And he added, "I have not spoken to a single person yet that thinks this is a good idea, not one." And then we've got a little box that says flood plan talks move. Okay. A special meeting of the full council has been called next Thursday to tackle a call from elected members for a halt to progress this white sand scheme. Probably got over what we've already been over. Yes, it's the same as what I've already read in the first part of page 3. Now we've got some adverts there from... We've got a winter sale on. Where is the winter sale? Dumfries Bed Centre has a winter sale on. Starts Tuesday the 27th of December. The Dumfries Carpet Centre... The Dumfries Bed and Carpet Centre. Is that the same? 7785 English Street. Must be the same people, is it? Fair enough. And they've got a sale on. And there's some other adverts on page 2. We've got Stove Designs, and they're... Where are they based? It doesn't actually say, but it's got their 01576. What's 01576? Is that Annan? I'm not sure where 01576 is. Well, give them a ring if you're looking for a stove. Got some nice ones there. So we're on page 4 now. And the headline says budget settlement will leave 20 million gap. Ooh, what's this about? What are we talking about here? I'm not sure what this is actually talking about. Let's have a look. I don't want to read it all out. I just want to get the highlights really. Give me a wee second just to see what it's saying. It's the budget for the council budget for next year is going to be 20 million short. Is that what they're saying? Budget settlement will leave 20 million gap. I might as well read this. The Labour administration says a straight cash cut of 12.5 million joins a need to find nearly 7.5 million for agreed extra costs, such as 1% pay rise for staff. Council leader Ronnie Nicholson said the details detailed analysis of the budget confirms that our worst fears, and that means we will have to find £20 million in cuts or extra income. Councillor Nicholson says up to £3.8 million could be generated by the government's increase in council tax on homes above Band D. What band am I? Don't know. I don't think I'm Band D. Is that like a high band? I think it is, isn't it? And an option for the council to raise the tax by up to 3%. Goodness. But he said the other £16 million will need to come from cuts in services. And with over £70 million already saved since 2012, he dubs further savings a huge challenge. So it's talking about more cuts to the council. What have we got here? We've got deaths, family notices, we've got deaths, we've got Smith, Elsie on the 18th of December 2016. Rest in peace, darling. We've got Harrison. It is with great sadness the family of Andrew Harry Harrison. So he died on the 20th of December 2016. Did you say when he was born? No. Let's have a look at the first one, LC. Let's have a look. Service at Rupin Lock on Friday the 30th of December at 12 noon. That's for LC Smith. What does it say about Andrew Harry Harrison? Rupin Lock, where is it? I don't know if it's at the Rupin Lock or not. The funeral service will take place in the United Reformed Church on Thursday the 29th of December at 11 a.m. Thereafter to Annan Cemetery, to which all his friends are respectfully invited to attend. And then we've got In Memoriam. You've got Little, Murdoch, Sec. Sick, that's a funny name, isn't it? I wonder what nationality that is then. S-E-K, I've never heard that in Scotland. We've got Stitt and we've got Watson. Little John Little died in 2015, and who's the, it just says Murdoch, Tommy Murdoch, it doesn't say when. And then Janice Seck died in 2014, and Bobby Stitt was 2013, that's December as well. Oh, they're all December, these ones, aren't they, obviously. And then Watson, who's that? Doesn't say who it was, which Watson. Okay. And we've got a winter sale of bits and pieces of Norman furnishings. Winter sale on, that starts at 10 a.m. Tuesday 27th of December. And page 6 here. Hundreds give views on town centre future. Goodness, there's a lot going on in the town, isn't there? So hundreds of people give their views. It's a lot of reading there. Have I got enough video to read all this? A survey, this is hundreds give views on town centre future. A survey focused on the future of Dumfries Town Centre has sparked a strong response. And Matt Baker from The Stove says the fact more than 700 people have taken part in under a week just demonstrates an underlying passion for the town. Hailing the response to the Mid-Stable Quarter public consultation, Matt said the idea of the survey was to give people who weren't able to come into the event we did at Baker's Oven a chance to get involved and show their support. We're up to over 700 responses, which is extraordinary. Matt added, in our wildest dreams, we were thinking that we might get a couple of hundred if we were lucky, but it's gone a bit mad. The two-day Chapter 1 event at the former Baker's Oven in the High Street, by the way, that's end of quote, the mad, in the High Street, said last month, kick-started a bid to engage the public and explore alternative options for Dumfries Town Centre and its many empty properties. The survey asked whether people would be interested in living in the town centre, what kind of housing they might want to see, the look and feel of the town centre, and uses for the town in enterprise and education, not just retail. And Matt said, what we're getting is that people really care about the town, because what happens in the town centre really is an indicator for the way people feel about the town generally. He says people care about the impression the town gives and have memories of what a busy, bustling, vibrant place it was. And while the council have a role to play in regeneration, Matt says that the artists collective can have an impact. The initiative is already gaining national interest, with Scottish Minister for Housing and Local Government Kevin Stewart interested in visiting in the new year, and the team spoke at Scotland's Towns Partnership recent conference in Kirkcaldy. Matt notes that new right to buy legislation due, which could allow community organisations to express an interest in private properties which are not being fully used, potentially taking them over. And he says discussions are underway with Baker's Oven owners, the council, about transferring it to a community company, urging more people to participate in the survey via the Stove's Facebook page. Matt said, we're wanting to build a business case for what we're proposing in the Mid-Stable Quarter and looking to see what people are going to support, particularly around Baker's Oven in the first instance, as that part of it will be probably go quicker than the big picture. We're looking to do that first. And it goes on to say, cross-party political backing has added to the Dumfries pledge, as people are invited to help support the town centre. Artist collective The Stove says politicians of all colours are joining the public in signing their commitment, with more than 200 signatures now collected. Names including MSPs Joanne McAlpine or Joan McAlpine, Oliver Mundell and Colin Smythe. The pledge can still be signed in The Stove in Dumfries High Street, but there is also an option in the online survey. Matt said, even if we've got a third of what that 700 who've signed up to that, it's pushing 500 on the pledge, which is a pretty wonderful thing. And there's a picture of Joanne McAlpine adds her signature to the initiative, the Dumfries Pledge, aimed at encouraging people to pledge their support to regeneration of the town centre. Last week, Ms. McAlpine lodged a motion in the Scottish Parliament praising The Stove for their success in the Creative Regeneration category at a National Regeneration Awards ceremony. Fantastic. So this is bid for 25 new homes in Maxwellton. This is a new thing. New story, okay? Bid for 25 new homes in Maxwellton. An application by an energy company to build a residential development comprising 25 new houses on the outskirts of Dumfries is being recommended for approval. The recommendation by planning officials comes despite 20 objections being lodged against the scheme. And now councillors are on the planning applications committee will consider the application from Certis Energy UK Limited for approval in principle for the residential development of the Maxwell Station Road in Terregles Road, Dumfries. The application site is a former fuel and oil storage and distribution depot in northwestern Dumfries and it extends to around 1.76 hectares. And it goes on. So that looks interesting. Okay. What else have we got there? We've got an advert from the Aldi. We've got an advert from the Care Shop. And it says your Super 6 will be 19p each. Fantastic. And we've got some shoes from the Care Shop. Okay, I'm going to just stop this filming just now, this audio. So I'm on page 7 now, and I'm going to read. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a look at the headlines and just make a decision. So, oh my goodness, yes. Well, it says a DGHP hit with £8,000 fine over carbon monoxide dangers. It possibly speaks for itself. It's two properties. Failing to identify a risk of carbon monoxide poisoning to visitors and residents at the two properties. That was in two homes, obviously, in Annan and Dumfries. And they're taking steps, I'm sure. Processes are now in place to forensically manage and supervise this kind of work. Obviously, they've had teams in and it's just not been done right. And the next story says, town pubs targeted by thieves. Thieves have targeted two Dumfries pubs in the space of a week, sparking a police investigation. Around £600 of scrap lead from copper pipes was stripped from the Stakeford Arms, oh that's terrible, on College Street, sometime between Saturday and Monday. And then the Traquair Arms saw the gaming machine hit and their money inside stolen overnight between Monday and Tuesday. And then we've got more vandalism. Gravestones were ruined after a despicable act in a Dumfries cemetery. Paint was poured over gravestones in St Michael Street Cemetery, but only two were targeted in completely different areas of the grounds. Apparently these two have been targeted before, Police Scotland say. And they're appealing for witnesses to catch whoever is responsible. We've got a court file. As usual, they're just nippers, aren't they? Most of them, 22, 20s and 30s. We've got assaulting. We've got breach of bail. And we've got drugs. I'm not going to name any names because I don't want any reprisals. And we're on page 8. Let's see if there's any adverts. Sorry, I'll go back to page 7 and see if there's any adverts. Oh, yes, there is. There's Gretna Gateway, up to 70% off. When's that? I suppose when it's open next, isn't it? Yeah. It's up to 70% off in the shops. Gretna Gateway. What have we got here? Page 8. A woman, a kind-hearted businesswoman from Dumfries says reveal plans to establish a centre in the town to support young people. Fantastic. And we've got another advert, and it's Dumfries Furniture Direct, Annan Road, Dumfries. Starts on Tuesday the 27th of December. That's a sale. Our first ever real sale, it says. Okay. We've got court file again. Yep. That all happens, doesn't it? And then there's a woman sentenced after stabbing at a rowdy party. We've got court file, more court file. We've got barbers, a winter sale. Starts on 27th of December. About 9:30. We're on page 10. And there's people remembering Christmas past. We have a winter sale. Where are we? Where's the winter sale? It's another big barber's page. All sorts of things on sale that you can buy at barber's. What have we got? We're on page 12 now. We've got Margaret Thatcher on there for some reason. It says, former Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher was last week controversially named the most influential woman of the last 70 years by a Woman's Hour panel. The decision was based on the fact she redefined power. Runner-up was Helen Brooks, and other winners include Labour MP Barbara Castle and feminist Germaine Greer. We asked readers who their top choice would be. So a chap here from Dumfries says, I think Lauren Hill from the Fugees. Lassie from Annan says, oh, can't even pronounce the name. Malala Yousafzai. She stood up for female education. And another young lassie from Dumfries says Malala Yousafzai. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. And lassie from Eastwick, just another young woman, Rosa Parks. So she was an inspiration to females. That's grand. What have we got here? Still on page 12. So we've got cash better kept for services. Boundary change needs blocked. What are we talking about here? Political impact of plan. Humorous observation recalled. We are talking about, in the first cash better kept for services, we're talking about super fast broadband. I'll read that. South of Scotland MSP, Councillor Colin Smythe, chaired a meeting of councillors concerned about the rollout and delivery of super fast broadband across Dumfries and Galloway, he reported in With the ongoing problem of poor coverage, Mr. Smythe called for this summit to get to the bottom of these frustrations and give our local communities some answers. Quite so, one might well ask, on what terms and conditions? 12.6 million of council cash was handed over to the telecom network. As council employees and council taxpayers await with trepidation the next round of service cuts, they should consider the apparent naivety of Dumfries and Galloway Council, who indirectly hastened these cuts with their 12.6 million contribution. If ever fully completed, lucky users will likely be called upon to pay a premium to access the superfast broadband, deal or no deal. What are we talking about here? Boundary change needs blocked. What are we talking about? Can't see really any highlights in that. Political impact of plan. I think it's about the same thing. Traffic lights concerned. There was a number of near misses when the new Annan traffic lights were yet again out of action for an extended period this weekend. Page 13. We've got an advert, we've got some election stuff. Tory election choices. Page 14. We've got Dumfries people. And we obviously the borders have had to switch. What are you saying here? They've moved to all the ship. They're moving, okay. So there's a regiment moving. So the wee article here, summer boom for tourism. A successful summer season is being celebrated by businesses throughout the region. With 2016 drawing to a close, Visit Scotland Regional Director Doug Wilson said, "When I speak to the businesses across Dumfries and Galloway, they tell me that they have experienced a successful summer season. We hope that many more people will continue to share their own treasured stories and images of Dumfries and Galloway with us through our social media channels to ensure that we continue to let people know about the hidden gems to be discovered in the region." Rather than resting on the laurels of the past year, however, Mr. Wilson is already looking forward to next year. He said next year gets off to a great start with Big Burn Supper and a look. And looking ahead, we have exciting developments planned across the region, including the Peter Pan Moat Bray Trust and further developments at Lagan Outdoor. As we approach a new year, I would like to take the opportunity to remind people that 2017 is the year of history, heritage and archaeology. We have a region rich in historical attractions, unique abbeys and stunning big houses, not to mention some amazing events and festivals. I'm excited about the many opportunities that the year ahead will bring. Fantastic. We've got an advert, which is from the Aldi. Got a whole leg of fresh British lamb, £4.95 per kilo. We've got some duck, venison, beef, salmon. Oh, lovely! I like salmon. Smoked? Is it Scottish salmon? I don't know, is it smoked? That £20. Wow. And we've got a turkey. We also have another advert on the other side, which I didn't get on. No, it's just it is an advert. Brian Carson. He's just saying congratulations to the Lorburn Centre on their 25-year anniversary. Okay. Brian Carson, are they a developer or did they build the Lorburn Centre? I don't know. Okay, let's go next page. So this is the Lockerbie bombing, page 16. Nasty. I remember it. My grandmother lived there I remember we were in Berlin, and my father was fast-tracked to Lockerbie. I mean, he was there in a heartbeat. Just phoned up the commanding officer and said, "The plane's gone down Lockerbie, you've heard?" And he said, "Yes, I have." And my mother lives there, you better go then. He got him up on a plane in a fast car and he was there. So it's the anniversary of that awful event. And Monaghan's is, what's it saying about Monaghan's? So they've moved to a brand new store right in the centre of the town. The new site is situated across from the Midsteeple in Queensbury Square. Okay, that's Monaghan's have moved. Got a wee advert for Border Meats. Oh my goodness, can I hardly see it. And we've got another vandalism, case of vandalism. 9 cars at Dumfries Garage were attacked. Wanton vandalism. Police Scotland are investigating. And they're looking at the CCTV, and there's a big massive page 17 Monaghan's advert. And then we've got on page 18, we've got bits and pieces going on for this time of year. Relative to this time of year, we've got the TV guide. More TV guide. And more TV guide. And we're on page 23, which is all the adverts. We've got an advert for Perfect Retreat in Annan. We've got, I'll go down and then I'll go across. Bathroom and Plumbing Solutions attack. BB Body Repairs. We've got The Butchers, John Kerr and Sons. Galloway Industrial, Power Transmission Publishers. What's this? It doesn't actually have a name. Maybe it's just an empty it's an empty space for an advert. Okay. Garage Services LP Motors Eastrix, LMP. Plumbing Derek Scott. We've got a builder, Kay Carlisle. Did I say Bridgend Garage? Yeah. Joinery, John S. Brawls. And we've got funeral directors, that's J&A Hodgson. And we've got some little adverts down on page 22. Solway Agricultural Limited, Annandale Bed and Bath Service, and T.N. Mackay, TBs. It says buy local best value. With Garage Doors by David Shepherd. What on the next page? And we've got Going Out. What have we got going out? The Buccleuch Centre in Langham will be screening a performance of the hit Broadway stage play No Man's Land on Thursday the 29th of December. And it looks like Patrick Stewart's in it. Oh, it might not be, but it could be because he's in the photo there. Let's have a look. Two aging writers, Hurst and Spooner. There seems to be quite a couple of good actors there, unless that's the original. Not sure. Yep, and there's some adverts here. The Royal Theatre, we've got the Lonsdale Cinema, Social Club, we've got Huggy Bear. What have we got on? We've got Sans Panto. What does that say? It's not really obvious, but obvious what it's saying. Just who's going to be in it. Oh, it's just a bit of news. Sans Pantel cast has talent. Okay. We've got a crossword and a Sudoku. And I don't believe in the stars, so I'm not even going to go there. Got more adverts. Who's this? Marshall Conservatory conversions. We've got the blind specialists. Autistic blinds, DATS blinds, CB blinds, Lockerbie, mobile carpets, Pets Corner, and we've got more adverts, tons of them. Goodness, I'll be there all day. Okay, we've got recruitment here, care opportunities, at the new Johnson Matthew Annan site. We've got the Dumfries and Galloway College. We've got a permanent part-time construction technical support assistant. Okay. What does that involve? All of our posts attract an excellent career average pension scheme and non-contributory life assurance. Didn't say anything about the post. Let's just ring them or go on to dongal.ac.uk. Grace and Graham, I've got a big sale. Ends 31st of Dec, 31st of December. So, got a new car going there. Bus flags, I've got a sale. From the 4th and the 31st of January, cross flags, I've got a sale. Cross flags, Nissan have a sale too. Is it? I don't think it's a sale, it's just an advert. And then we've got Ben Hodgson Cars Limited, that's a big ad. Where is that then? Oh, it's in Dalston, Carlisle, okay. Fine. We've got Board of Cars, advertising the cars. MOT at Kirkpatrick's. Townhead Street, Lockerbie. Scrap cars wanted. There's a car for sale here, a 2003 Skoda. That's because I was reading the Skoda Fabia, all in one word. Skodio, that's very good. Skoda Fabio 1.9, 695, or very near its offer. We've got a Vauxhall van here, a big van, 2 litre. It's a Vauxhall Vivaro 2 litre TDCILWB 5495, no van, no offers. What else have we got? We've got sports. Revenge is sweet for on fire Saints. Fantastic. Short mat bowls, pool darts, Teen Stars head for town. So that's at the ice bowl. Queen of the South manager Gary Nay Smith. Looking for to win tomorrow. That would have been past, that would have been Saturday, was it? So we don't know the score of that one. Right, what else have we got? We've got the back page. What have we got on the back page? Border cars again. Well, that's just been there. I was quite happy I did that because I never usually read the courier right through, so it was interesting just to read it. I'm going to stop this narration just now just so I can save, because I've spoke quite a lot. I don't want to lose it. Alright, So I'm going to stop the video now. That's just me being just reading the courier. I'm just having a bit of fun. But if you enjoyed it, that's fantastic, you know. And you could see my run from. I went to Lockerbie to drop off the cameras, and then I went over the old Ray 74 to Moffat, to beat it, in fact, and then I turned back it onto A701 at Dumfries just to give the bike, charge the battery up on the bike. It needs that now and again. Especially I just don't go very far in the winter. Just go around the town. I thought it's not a bad day, you know. A wee bit wet and windy, but it's okay. It wasn't wet. You can see on the camera it wasn't that wet. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, please leave a comment, and please like it, and please subscribe. It helps me out a lot. And thanks very much for listening and watching.